Let us start again by defining negative thoughts. I'll share a secret with you. The human brain cannot tell the difference between reality and imagination. Yes, you heard me right. This is to a great extent due to the way our brain is built. In very simple terms, we have a structure in the brain called the reticular activating system and the existence of mirror neurons. This system and these neurons basically allow us to experience things as if they're true, things that are not happening there and then, simply by imagining or retrieving them from our memory. That is why, for example, we may cry in a moving movie, get angry simply by remembering what somebody told us the other day, or get frightened by what might happen to us tomorrow. So now you know. The effect of negative thoughts. Thoughts recreate emotional experience, even for events that never happen. Again, I'm going to answer the question by taking one step back and asking some more questions. Write them down if you want. How do I create negative thoughts? What are the thoughts I'm reflecting upon and I consider or label them as negative? What happens just before, during, and after I get these thoughts in my body and in my behavior? Now, self-observation is very valuable. It's a very valuable skill that can be applied to so many areas of self-development and emotional management. Let us be the detectives of our behavior. Let us inquire with curiosity. Could we be the creators of our own fake news? Once we have observed and identified what exactly happens with negative emotions, how and when they happen, negative thoughts tend to lose their grip and power over us.